Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Summers. Morey Amsterdam. Carolyn Jones. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
That's me. Hello there. How do you do? How do you do? Thank you. Hi, Johnny. All right. Let's say hello to these beautiful and talented people. Hello, beautiful and talented people.
Oh.
All right, that's enough out of you. Okay, now let's say hello to these two beautiful people, Sue Yannick and Marilyn Countryman. Now, we've had some pretty good games going here between these two ladies, and the last time we met, we were right in the middle of a tiebreak. 3-0 in favor of the challenger in the middle of the tiebreaker. And now let's complete the tiebreaker here and go to Sue Yannick's assignment. Everyone plays This Is It. Name a foreign car. Name a foreign car. Okay, all set up there. Let's see which car Sue names. Which one, Sue?
Volkswagen.
VW is what she said. Okay, 3 to stay in the game, 4 to win it. Bert, name a foreign car.
It's German, but it's a Mercedes.
Mercedes.
Yeah.
No match there. Brett?
I'm sure you've all heard the expression small time printed on her rear end.
Yeah.
Volkswagen.
There it is. There's one match for you, Sue. Maury?
I want it in an Italian restaurant.
A Fiat. Okay. Carolyn, name a foreign car.
I like this one because I like the name. Volvo.
Volvo. Okay. Now, you must match the two remaining celebrities to stay in the game. Let's see if it happens. Richard.
The trouble with Volkswagen is when you start them up, they declare war on you. Volkswagen.
Need one more to achieve the tie, Sue. Betty?
Oh, I'm under the gun again. A Volkswagen. Oh.
Another tie.
I can't believe it.
I got a great idea for the name of the show, Tiebreaker 73.
Tiebreaker 73. All right, I'll push the button and we'll go to another tiebreaker. Okay, Marilyn, make a selection. A, she's going to stick with A, this is it. Again, everyone will play. Brett, I think there's a card accidentally stuck in your, there it is.
Watch it.
Okay. Or you blow the fuse or something.
I never had any luck.
Name a place where you might find ice. A place where you might find ice. Name a place where you might find ice. You think about that. Okay, the celebrity's all ready, so let's get Marilyn's answer.
I will say the freezer.
The what?
Freezer.
The freezer. The freezer is her answer. Let's see what your answer is, Bert.
Yes, the freezer, sometimes known as the North Pole.
Okay, no match there. Brett?
I don't think I'm equipped to play this game. I also said the North Pole, and I can't even get it straightened out.
Well, North Pole was a good answer. You know, it was either freezer, refrigerator, or North Pole. One
I hardly agree with you, because I got North Pole, too.
Okay. Everybody up there said North Pole. Let's see what everybody down here says. Carolyn.
I'm the only one that's different. I said Alaska.
Alaska is a place where you might find ice. And Richard Dawson.
That's because Carolyn, of course, is a pole from the North, so I naturally said North Pole. Poor devil.
All right. Let's see if you score with Betty White.
It'll be a cold day, and I said the icebox. But I was just reminiscing.
That is a match, so you score one. Okay. Now let's see if you need one to achieve another tie. However, two will win the game for you, Sue, and it'll be your fourth game. Name a flavor of ice cream. Name a flavor of ice cream. Ready up there. All right, let's find out which ice cream Sue is going to name.
Vanilla.
Vanilla is what she says. I guess that's about the most popular. One to tie, two to win. Bert, name your flavor.
One to tie. There it is, vanilla.
There is the tie. Two to win, Brett.
Well, it was either chocolate or vanilla, but with my usual run of luck.
Chocolate. Vanilla wins another game for Sue over here.
I didn't know how to spell tutti frutti, so I put vanilla.
That's another $100 for you. Stand right there. Marilyn, it's been a pleasure meeting you. We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for playing Match Game 73, Marilyn Countryman. Now, somehow, my microphone was not in its usual place, my hand mic, so I'm going to hold this one out here and share that
Gene,
with you.
Gene, the switchboard is lighting up with marriage proposals.
This gal is up to $6,900, and no wonder. Now, you know how this super match goes. This is your fourth game, so let's get right to it. We polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Flower blank. Flower blank. The answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Three celebrities will be allowed to help you, so why don't you start choosing right now?
Bert?
Bert, how do you fill in that blank?
Thank you. Flower? I think I would say flower pot first.
Richard?
Flower power.
Flower power.
That's when you get killed by a rose.
Okay, you got flower power from Mr. Dawson. Who else?
Carolyn.
Flower blank.
Flower child.
Flower child is what she said. So you've got flower pot, flower child, and flower power. You may choose one of those, as you know, or you may give us one of your own, but we need an answer right now.
Flower pot.
Flower pot. Okay, there it is. Flower pot. It's the answer Bert Convy gave you. We're looking for flower pot. May we see the $100 response? Flower child is up there. Carolyn gave you that one. All right, we're still looking for flower pot, the $250 response. Flower power, that's up there too. That's the one that Richard gave you. Here's your third and last chance. May we see the $500 response? Flower pot it is, we've got it again. Very good. Okay. You're over $7,000 at this moment.
I get velvet.
And now you're going for 10 times $500 again, or $5,000. You have to match one celebrity head-to-head. It's time to choose a celebrity now.
I'll stay with Bert.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You must be out by the morning.
Bert, you get ready to write. You face me again. Here is the question. Blank lighter. You write your answer to that, Bert. Blank lighter. L-I-G-H-T-E-R. Okay, he's finished. So now, Sue, you give us your response to this. Blank lighter.
Cigarette lighter.
Cigarette lighter is what she says. Bert, for $5,000, hold everything now for... We've got to see Bert's answer, and it's got to say cigarette lighter if she's going to win the $5,000. Bert, may we see it?
She's going to win another $5,000.
Wow. That's enough. We'll be back as soon as we can separate the two people up there. Here's our current champ, who set a new record as far as this program is concerned. She has a total of $12,400 to her credit. She She's got some definite plans as to what she wants to do with that money, and I think she ought to tell you about it.
I'll spend it on my education, and I'll go to Europe.
Good girl.
You gonna go to the education first or Europe first?
Probably Europe.
Oh.
That's an education.
Right, that is part of
yes,
your education. Well, good luck to you. You are going to meet another challenger, and here comes that challenger right now. There's Judy Bambus. Hi, Judy. Okay. You want to step around there and say hello to Judy Bambus? And we welcome you and ask you to tell us a little about yourself.
Okay, I'm a former airline stewardess, now married, the mother of one son, and I'm expecting my daughter in 2 months.
Okay. Now, you know that you and Sue answer questions in an attempt to match our six celebrities. You'll have two chances of that. The one who's done it most often at the end of the second round wins $100 and the right to go on to the super match where you can win a lot of money, yes, as this young lady has demonstrated already. Here we go to round one. Judy, would you make a selection?
Yes, I'll take B, please.
B is what she wants, and here we go. Everybody plays. It's a brand new game. Sally said...
Skip it.
Sally said, you got any other... No, that's...
Go on to the next.
Sally said, don't touch my blank. You know that's where I'm ticklish. Sally said that.
Is that, may I ask a question, sir?
Yes, sir. Sally said, don't touch my blank, you know that's where I'm ticklish.
It's a singular, it's not plural. Don't touch my blank, as opposed to blanks.
Well, it's up to you.
I wanted to clear that up.
I refuse to engage in this colloquy any further.
In this what? I beg your pardon. Okay.
Sally said, don't touch my blank, you know that's where I'm ticklish. Are you all ready?
Yes. Oh, I'm...
You are down here.
Of course.
What are you doing up there?
I'm ready now.
Okay. Now, Judy, we call on you for your response.
I'll say tummy.
Tummy is what she says. Don't touch my tummy. You know that's where I'm ticklish. Bert, what do you say?
It starts with a T, but it comes out thigh.
Thigh. Okay. Brett,
you lisp a lot.
Well, I tell you, I tried to think of all the places that I was ticklish.
Yes.
But it's been so long, I've forgotten. I finally came up with navel.
Navel. That's in the area of the tummy. Can we match that? We can match that. Okay. So there's one match. Morey, what do you say?
Well, I was just wondering how far the toes are from the navel.
Long way. And Carolyn?
Well, if the toes are that far, how far away are the feet?
Feet are still a long way from the tummy.
You're a lot older than I am, honey.
Richard, what do you say?
I just want to tell Brett that if her belly button is ticklish, that's probably lint. So I said tummy.
Tummy! There's a match. Another one for you, Judy. And Betty.
Well, if Judy's expecting her daughter in 2 months, her tummy is more than ticklish. I said ribs.
Her ribs. So you scored twice, and now we'll go to Sue's assignment, which is as follows, and everyone will participate. This has to be an exact match. Give us a slang word for girl. A slang word for girl. All right, they're all ready. Sue, what do you say? A slang word for girl.
Abroad.
Abroad? Okay. Okay, that's her word, and these will have to be exact. Bert, what do you say?
Is broad close enough?
Broad is close enough. There's one match for you. All right, Brett, may we see yours?
I think she comes from Jack Klugman's old neighborhood. Broad.
Broad. There you go. We got a tie score at this moment.
You spell it the same way when you say you studied abroad?
Yes, that's it. Okay, so you've matched everyone up there, and let's see what happens down here. Carolyn.
She's broad where abroad should be broad.
There it is. Another one for you. And Richard Dawson.
Well, although I disapprove of this word, I said chick, and I'd get rid of her, but I need the eggs.
And Betty White.
Easy over.
She said lady.
But a good psychiatrist straightened him out. I said dame.
A dame. So you did pretty well with that. You matched four celebrities, and so the score at the end of round one is 4-2 in favor of our current champ, and we'll come back to our two players right after this. At the end of round one, scores 4-2 in favor of our current champ, Sue Yannick. And now let's go to round two. Judy, would you make a selection?
I'll stick with B.
B is what she wants. Now, last time around, you matched two of our celebrities, Richard Dawson and Brett Summers. And now you'll be trying to match all the others. Name something that has gas.
So glad I'm not in this round.
Pointed me, sir.
You mind repeating that?
Name something that has. Name something that has gas.
Said, would you mind
all finished over there.
Him?
Okay, let's find out what this lady's response is. What do you say, Judy?
I'll say a car.
A car has gas. All right. Let's find out what Bert Convy's answer is.
I took you literally. I said a stomach has gas.
Stomach has gas.
I said.
All right, Morey, what do you say?
Ethel is opposed.
Not his stomach. My stomach has gas.
Your stomach has gas. All right, now you must match the two remaining celebrities to stay in the game and score a tie. Carolyn?
Well, I took you literally, too. I said a stove.
A stove. You did not match there, so Sue Yannick wins another game. Congratulations, Sue. Okay, there's another 100 for you. And for you, Judy, we have a gift backstage together with our thanks for being with us here on Match Game 73. Let's say goodbye to Judy Bandler.
You've done it again. That's old Sue again. There she is.
Gene, you better take this girl out and have her bronzed.
She's up to $12,500. This is her fifth game, and here we go again with the super match. First, the audience match part of it. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this.
What is
bed blank.
What?
Bed blank. B-E-D blank. Now, as you know, the answer given most often by the studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it, the second $250 and the third $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Start choosing.
Bert.
I'll say, let's say bedroom first.
Bedroom is his. Okay, you've got one. You need two more.
Betty.
Bedtime.
Bedtime is what she says. And one more celebrity, Sue.
Richard.
Bed bug. It's a Watergate invention. To hear if you're coming or going. It should be very exciting.
All right, so you've got bedroom, bed bug, and bedtime. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What do you choose to do?
I'll choose bedroom.
You'll choose bedroom. Okay.
Well, you go in the motel before me and I'll come in.
Okay, we're looking for bedroom. May we see the $100 response? Bed bugs.
Well, I was crazy, didn't you?
Sure.
It doesn't mean you're not crazy.
Richard's answer, we're still looking for bedroom. May we see the $250 response? Bedtime, that's up there also. That's the one that Betty gave you. All right, here's your third and last chance. We are looking for bedroom. The $500 response. Bedroom it is again. Done it again. There's the $500 for you. You're up to $13,000 even now. Now you're going to play for 10 times $500 or $5,000. And now it's time to choose a celebrity for the head-to-head match.
Bert.
Okay. Bert, you get ready right. You face me, Sue. Face me, I know. He's a lovely fellow and all that, but you... Better face me here. All right, Bert, here it is. $5,000. Write your answer to this. Private blank. Private blank. Okay. Bert's finished his answer, and now we call for your response, Sue. Private blank.
Private eye.
Private Eye. All right, Bert, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
That's a good one, and it's a tough question. I said Private Entrance.
Private Entrance. So you did not match there. However, you're up to an even $13,000. That's going to may prove to be a lucky number for you. Who knows? You're going to meet another player, and we're going to do that right after these words. Time is up for today. We'll look forward to seeing Sue Yannick next time when she'll meet a new player. I want to thank our beautiful people over here, our celebrated people, for being so terrific today. You're really terrific. I mean, terrific.
What panel is this you're talking about?
This is the very same group here. Bert, you're involved in a new motion picture, aren't you? You want to tell us a little about that?
We're going to start shooting it shortly, Gene, here in Los Angeles, and 4 weeks in Spain, and 5 weeks in the Middle East.
Okay.
Providing that there's no trouble.
We're doing it in Super 8.
Masquerade.
We'll look forward to seeing that, and hope look forward to seeing you next time. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are a West clock, direct reading digital dial and alarm clock, wood grain finish, lighted dial, backed by years of experience, West Clocks, a Tally Industries company. And an assortment of candy featuring Chunky, extra thick for extra flavor, delicious bit of honey, Luber's chocolate-covered peanuts, Raisinets, famous O. Henry candy bar. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.